The internet is glorious. I love it and it enables me to make videos that helps other people with ADHD. It entertains me and it teaches me, but it also wastes my time and distracts me. So how can we use technology to help us manage our ADHD better? I want to go over the 9 best extensions and apps that you can use for ADHD. Over the years, I have found some incredible programs, apps, and extensions that are suitable for different aspects of my ADHD. Note that I'm not sponsored by any of these apps or extensions, I simply find them helpful with managing certain symptoms of my ADHD. First up is distraction-free YouTube. Since you are probably watching this on YouTube, this extension might be for you. Do you sometimes go on YouTube and watch something specific, and after an hour of being distracted, you have fallen down the YouTube rabbit hole and are now watching some animal vine video or a best amazing top 10 video? Then this extension might help you tremendously. It will make your YouTube page go from this to this, and watching videos goes from this to this. It will make you more aware of what you want to watch because you have to actively search for it. If you have to do research on a specific topic, this will help you stay focused and not be distracted by the recommended videos. It's free and available for multiple browsers, and I will put a link in the description. Next is number 2, Leechblock. This is an extension that I use all the time. With this extension, you can block certain sites from being accessed. I have a tendency to go on certain sites when I'm distracted or bored, almost unconsciously. I made a special block set that is set between 9 a.m. and 5 p.m. where I cannot access certain sites, like social media, forums, or video streaming sites. You can also set a daily timer, so if you have a tendency to be on Reddit for hours on end, you can set a daily timer for 30 minutes a day. This way you have more time for things that actually matter in life. Continuing on this topic is number 3. It is called Brain Focus. It is a productivity app for your phone and it uses the Pomodoro technique, which has been shown to improve focus and keep up your productivity. In the options, you can set it so it blocks all notifications. It is also a great app that I use while working on these videos to keep me focused and productive while reminding me to take a break so I don't lose concentration. The free option is good enough for me, and there is a pro version which will give you more options. Number 4 is Digital Wellbeing app. It's a standard app from Google and it might already be on your phone. Just search for it with a search bar. It gives you insight in how much you are using your phone, how much you pick up your phone during the day, and in my opinion, the most important feature, you can set a time limit for your apps. So you won't scroll endlessly through social media or play that mobile game for 3 hours straight. Then there is another easy function that is called focused mode. In this mode, you can only use certain apps that you have pre-selected and you won't get any notifications during that time. It's free and very easy to use, and a lot of people already have it pre-installed on their phone. Now if you don't have a Google phone or Android, there is another option, like Freedom, which also lets you use timers for your apps and also has a focused mode. Number 5. Grammarly. A lot of people with ADHD also have dyslexia, and so do I. On top of that, I am not a native English speaker. So Grammarly makes sure that most of the text that I write in English will be correct. It will correct punctuation, capitals, spelling, and even weird sentences. It is also extremely easy to use. Grammarly is an extension that you can download for your browser. And there is also an app that you can use on your phone. The free option is very good, although when funds allow it, I'm probably going to upgrade to premium. Number 6. Sleep Cycle. This app is my go-to alarm clock. This isn't a regular alarm clock though. This app actually helped me improve my sleep quality. It has 2 main functions that are helpful for me. First, it measures your sleep quality during the night by using your microphone to see how much you toss and turn at night and to measure your sleep cycles. In addition, it also lets you know how much you have snored. This is helpful for knowing which certain activity decrease or increase your individual sleep quality. The other function that I love the most about this app is the alarm clock. In a half-hour window, it will measure when you are awake the most, and then the alarm will go off. This way, you will wake up less groggy, and you won't be woken up in the middle of your REM cycle, which might happen with a normal alarm clock. This way, you will be more rested, and so you will be able to handle your ADHD better. This is all available in the free version, so why not give it a try? Number 7. F.lux. Since we were talking about sleep quality, this next application is also a must. It is for your PC and also available for both Mac and Windows. This simple program will decrease the blue light emitted by your screen. Since blue light will block your melatonin production, using your screen at night will decrease your sleep quality. So, with this application, your blue light intake will be reduced by a lot. It's free and easy to use, and it goes automatic. So try it out, the link is in the description. Of course, we would like to have this night mode on our phones too. Well, most phones have this built in already. But for me, I would like them to block a little more blue light, so I use an app for this. I have an Android, so I use Twilight. But if you have an Apple, you can download F.lux for your phone. Now, if you struggle with sleep, I already made a video on this, and I will put a link in the description. And also, you can click up here. Number 8. The normal calendar app on your phone. Every phone has a calendar app, pre-installed. And if you use it right, you will forget a lot less appointments or tasks you have set for yourself. I don't just have appointments in there, but also my regular workout routine, my meditation reminder, and my daily work schedule. With multiple reminders, since I tend to ignore or be right in the middle of something when the alarm goes off. You can also use any other calendar app, as they are pretty much all the same, as long as you set them up right. And then the last one, number 9, Evernote. There are a lot of note-taking apps out there, but I personally use Evernote. It's fast and easy to use, and I've bound it to my Bixby key on my phone. I tend to have lots and lots of random ideas for videos or coaching during the day. The problem is that if I don't write them down, they tend to be gone forever. I now try to write down all those random ideas, so I can use them later and don't forget them. It's free and it can sync between multiple platforms. Now those are the apps and extensions that I personally use, but since there are thousands of apps and applications out there, I would like to know what app or program you personally use that helps your ADHD. And when I have a larger list of suggestions, I will try them all out and make a part 2 of this video, so more people with ADHD may see them. So let me know about this in the comments, and don't forget to subscribe so you can be notified when part 2 comes out. And also to see more videos about improving your life when you have ADHD. I hope you have a great week, and I will see you in the next one.